Simon, do you want to answer some questions?
What is it you're doing? Are these questions for SIPs?
Yeah.
Yeah.
SIPs interview.
Yeah.
An evening with SIPs.
Yeah.
La la. An evening with SIPs.
Why are you singing Annie Lennox for an evening with SIPs?
It's a good song, isn't it, though?
It is, isn't it? I think it fits an evening with SIPs.
It is a pretty good song, actually. It's one of those ones that you're so embarrassed to sing. Like, but if you're in your car and your windows are all done up, you, like, just belt it out. It's fine.
Yeah, yeah. God, I do enjoy doing that. Okay. Guilty pleasure. Yeah. Hit us with the question, Sips.
Alright, hang on, let me just get a question.
Okay. I would have hoped you'd done a little bit more preparation.
I've done none. I'm actually just gonna, like, I wish my mouse wheel scrolled, like, you know, like I could, like, spin it like a roulette table or something, and it would just, like, slow down and then question. Stop on a question. That'd be great. But
I kind of imagine you rummaging around in a big, kind of, like, big yellow thread sack, you know, of questions. You know, a quite rough wool sack, usually sort of used to hold hay or grain.
It's more like putting like a big industrial strength rubber glove on and putting it into like a toilet that's just like full of of all sorts of like poo and everything, and then hoping that you'll rummage around in there and like find a diamond, but there's no diamonds in that toilet.
You're more likely to find a cotton bud, or like, oh god, I don't want to think what you might find.
A tampon. That's what you were thinking. A tampon.
Get the question quickly.
Okay, I'm just scrolling down. I'm getting them all loaded so I can just,
how many are there? God, it's taking you like 10 minutes.
There's 420.
What?
Oh, good lord. Sips, we've only got like half an hour. We can't do 420.
I know. We're not going to do them all now.
What? 420 ask Sips a question every day.
Yeah. Actually, there's 422. But close. A lot of them are unanswerable. They're just things like...
Oh, good.
Oh my god, why are you the best?
Skip those. There you go.
We can answer that one, though.
Wow.
Okay, alright.
It's more of a statement, really, isn't it?
It's a
rhetorical
kind of,
question.
Yeah. Alright, let's try this one. Sips, have you ever considered running for leader of Canada? I'm English, but I'd still vote for you! ! And that was from Xav the Mod. That was his question.
That's a good question.
So first of all, I don't think he could vote, because I don't think that's how it works. At all, actually.
But are you a Canadian citizen? Have you got dual citizenship? Have you got dual citizenship?
Yeah, I do. So I could.
How does that work? It's like the back half of your passport Canadian and the front half England.
What?
And you have to like turn them upside down.
The bottom half of SIPs is Canadian.
Yeah, that's what...
It's like on the Bourne Identity. I have a different name in Canada than I do in England, and when I travel around... Like, across the world, I have, like, 7 different passports.
Oh my god, you're like Jason Bourne.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly like that.
What are your other names, Sips, in other countries?
I was lying, I don't have other names. I don't even have multiple passports, actually.
Are your other names, like, anagrams of Sips? I can't...
Yeah.
I can't think of any.
I can only think of one. And maybe it would be inappropriate on a passport, although, you know, you can do a lot of stuff with Deadpool these days.
What would you change your name to, though, Sips, if you had an opportunity? And also, did you keep your... When you married your wife, did you change name to her name?
Did you keep your maiden name?
Yeah, did you keep your maiden name?
Did I keep my... Yeah, I... I think if I could rename myself, I would change my name to Ronald Schwarzenegger, because I think it's better than Arnold. I think Ronald's a better name. I think it goes better with his last name, too. And
it's
and
more
I would,
American.
I would make it a point. It is,
Ronald.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ronald.
You can see that, but I mean, wouldn't he go a step further, though, and call himself Ronald Swartz or something like that? You know, shorten it even further so it's even less kind of Germanic.
No, I quite like the Schwarzenegger. I think it adds character to the name.
You like the end bit, okay. I don't know.
I'm not sold on Arnold. I think
it's difficult to spell, you know? I think on a modern day, you know, in a modern environment, people would look up his name, they wouldn't be able to spell it, they'd just give up. You know, you have to have something that's easy to spell, to market yourself.
I don't know, I mean, he's done pretty good. Like all those, like, 1980s action movies.
Yeah.
You know, you just see his name plastered across the whole screen because, like, it barely fit on. Like, I don't even know if they could fit the whole thing on most of the time, but it looked cool. It's like two Zs in there.
I think there's at least two. And there's, like, a Q as well in there. It's like a high score in Scrabble.
The original question was, have I ever considered running for leader of Canada? But, like, how do people even, like, decide that that's what they want to do? Like, I'm sure everybody kind of thinks, like, at some point, oh, God, yeah, I'd love to, like, run the country.
There's, like, a form that you fill in at the post office.
Yeah.
If you want to be the leader.
You got to get passport photos.
Yeah, it's a lot of hassle. You have to fill out this form. It's a couple of pages long. You know, you have to buy stamps and you have to post it. A lot of people don't bother with the hassle.
Do you think there's, like, some kind of interview or something where they're, like, so what makes you think you'd be a good leader of Canada? I don't know. I mean, who decides that?
Who does the interview? The old leader? Or, like...
You know who decides? The Illuminati. Those
are
the people who decide. Come on.
The smoking man.
The Canadian Illuminati.
The Canadian Illuminati, yeah. Oh, man.
The Illuminati A.
Wow.
Wow. Very nice. Very
well
nice.
Done. Well done. I tip my hat. I doff my hat to you, good sir.
So the Illuminati A are in control of Canada behind the scenes, and they just put a puppet leader. So I guess that begs the question. If you knew you were going to be a puppet leader, would you still, like, want to be one? Like, would you... Or maybe you'd just be, like, scared into it. Like, they would just threaten to, like, break your kneecaps or something.
Puppet leader? Or like Kermit the Frog?
Yeah.
Someone in charge of other puppets.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly like Kermit the Frog, yeah. Like, you just get up there and you're a Muppet and you were in charge of, like, a big country. Yeah, that would be nice. That would be good.
I would outlaw bacon, first of all.
Well, Kermit would, because of Miss Piggy.
Yeah, he'd want to make sure she was safe.
I don't know. I don't think Kermit even really likes her, though.
Oh, he does. You can see it in his eyes.
You can see it in his smile.
He probably, like, when he goes backstage after, like, hosting the Muppet Show, he probably just, like...
cries himself to sleep.
Yeah, just holds himself. Just, like, he's just, like, kneeling in the shower, crying, and the shower's cold, holding himself. He hates his life. Poor Kermit.
Oh, God.
He's got, like, a pair of, like, cloth scissors, and he's gonna, like, cut his wrists. Oh, God.
Why is he so depressed? Well, I guess he's got a man's fist up his ass. He's got a man's fist up his ass, and the only woman he finds him attractive is literally a pig.
And a really annoying one as well.
What would you prefer, though, being loved by a pig, an annoying pig, or if you had to choose, would it be being loved by the annoying pig or having a man's fist up your ass? If those were the only two options.
God, well, it's a hard one, isn't it? The only one who loves you is a pig. Or permanently having a man's fist.
It's kind of
like an insufferable pig, though. Not just like, not like a normal pig.
An insufferable pig. Okay.
A pig you absolutely can't stand.
Yeah, like you literally want to just gouge your eyes out, like right in front of her every time she talks to you.
Well, I mean, the choice is obvious, isn't it? The choice is obvious.
Yeah, it's the pig.
Pass me the cloth scissors. I'll just end it.
Oh man, poor Kermit.
God.
He's got a pretty terrible life. All right, well, that was question one. That was from Zav the Mod.
Oh Christ!
So I'm gonna close that,
that
one.
That was one.
That was one.
That was one.
We've only got 421 left to go.